All right, so this is 6.85. It's actually out. I'm Revo, joined here by Drag and Drop. We will see what's going on here. Let me make sure I eject this from the regular. So I've actually already looked at these a little bit, Drag and Drop, because somebody posted it. Wait, and more. Hold on. Reorganize the home page for neighborhood channels to find people in your area. What? That's... Yeah, but I could go outside for that, and I'm not gonna do that. And will remain open whenever you're in a lobby. Oh, the chat panel. That's good, actually. It's more like the original one. Oh, and it highlights the most spectated match at the moment. There's more features and fixes, but the rest isn't, like, groundbreaking. They made it sound like it was, like, 6.85 and more, like there was so much more that was about to happen or something. Yeah. So, general changes, there's very little. The biggest change is that Purge no longer deals bonus damage to summoned units. That's insane. Uh-huh. In other words, Warlock is now broken. I think. I mean, I'm assuming there has to be some change to him to keep things balanced, right? I mean, I guess the wiki is just wrong right now, because it's not going to know. Anyways, let's just go ahead and assume Purge does no longer kill the Siege Ancient Golem things. That's insane, because previously the worst part about playing Terrorblade is that you could just get purged and it didn't matter. Okay. Siege creeps now behave like normal lane creeps for spell targeting rules, so no longer is it just Dragon Knight, a Magnus, and other shockwave-type damages that affect them, but they do have 80% magic resistance. This is actually a big buff to pure damage overall. Like, let me turn that off. Yeah. Sonic Wave will do it now. It may have done it before, yeah. Okay, I will... Yeah, and then Ancient Thunderhide, that's the, like, Triceratops dinosaur. Okay. It's basically got a super drum aura. Wait a second. It's not an active ability. Holy chin! Or holy knight, rather. Haha. Oh! And then Ancient Black Drake with Dragonhide aura, 2 armor that's stackable. And you can get 3 Ancients, right? So, you could either get the whole combo, but I'm thinking you could get 6 armor as well. But you think about it for the creeps. Like, just for your lane creeps. Like, 6 armor's a lot. Yeah, that's true. Yeah. It's like Vlad's plus drum. Kind of. Without the lifesteal, obviously. Okay, and there's a bug with passive abilities not being affected by break. That's a bug fix, so can kind of ignore this. Abaddon, Mist Coil cooldown reduced. That's nice. Okay, the problem is he doesn't have the mana to sustain using it that much, unless it's super late game. And even then. I'd say the Axe is good though. Well, with this buff, you might see it picked up. Yeah. And then you really don't want to get the Axe. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, with Sol Ring, you can double spam it in one use, Illumini? Okay. That's actually viable, you could say. Alchemist is getting a what I'm gonna go ahead and say is a huge buff. Acid Spray is damage over time, of course, so it's not plus 3 damage, it's plus like I wanna say it's 10 seconds, so let's just say 30. Up to 60. Okay, it doesn't sound that much bigger, but it actually does damage now, on the other hand. Yeah. This is 500 gold at the start of the game. Yeah, this is. I think at this point it's actually worth dying if you can grab that rune. Level 1. So you're actually going to get more out of it, or even with the TP you're going to use to get back to lane, theoretically. The one thing I will say about this, I'd like to see a different buff to Alc. Simply because he doesn't have armor. His agility gain is terrible. Terrible. And I want to say he has one base armor. So that's still a problem. But again, Solar Crest, AC, there's things to fix that, you know? Yeah. Yeah, and giving him a buff to those bounty runes makes mid-alchemist much more viable. I mean, that's at least 50 extra gold from the previous patch, and it's a ton more gold from any patch before that, so. Yeah. Okay, it's a 400 megabyte patch, actually, and I'm just pulling it up to open up a lobby so I can test something if we have questions. We also have Ancient Apparition, Cold Feet cast range. This is a tiny buff. You can still walk away from it, though, and I feel like the problem is when, if you're casting it at 1,000 range, you're not in a position to even pressure someone to walk away from it. Now, if they're walking towards you, Okay. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Anti-Mage getting a slight nerf, although I would say this is kind of uncalled for, simply because he's been picked because of Lash and Storm. He hasn't been picked because he's as strong, you know? So it's a little sad to see, but it does give him a bit of an early game buff with the Mana Void because it's a slightly longer stun, but it's. Yeah. Yep, and so let's keep moving on from this. Bane, Enfeeble cooldown reduced. I still think this is an underrated ability, especially in terms of offlane Bane, simply because you can just put it on someone and say, haha, now you can't last hit at all. So that's going to be interesting. There's also a slight buff to the mana, actually, a pretty big buff to the early levels of Brainsap. You might not need to rush Sol Ring as hard on this one anymore. It could still be necessary though. So. Ah, here. Yeah, indeed. And let me just see if I can pull up Dota 2 Wiki as well. I should have just had this open, but anyways, let's move on while I look that up. Batrider, Flame Break, damage over time reduced slightly, but the duration is increased a lot. So, max level, it's now going to do 240 damage. But keep in mind, that's a blink that can't happen for that long. I think that's the biggest thing. So, that's decent. The big thing is the Ags upgrade. Batrider, I think, is going to be back in the meta. Wait a second. And also take advantage of it. He has 200 mana, level 1, by the way. Bane. That is. Yeah. Well, yeah. The other thing is, though, I'm assuming Sticky Napalm will work with this 100 damage per second, because it does work with Flame Break, and that's another thing to consider with Flame Break, is if there's 10 stacks of Napalm, that's what, 50 extra damage? And all of a sudden that's like 700 damage a second or something. Or 700 damage total, excuse me. 700 damage a second would be a little ridiculous. Four hundred range is not. It's the size of black hole, which I have seen. There's a slight change to that, but the size of black hole as we know it. Anyway, Bloodseeker. Oh, yeah. The other thing is that if these heroes are slightly grouped up, this kind of gives you 400 extra range on the lasso. Just right there, which is pretty big. Because that was one of the main ways lasso was nerfed, is in its cast range. And now, as long as you've got another hero there, it's actually more likely that you'd want to go for a 1v2 gank than a 2v1 gank, kind of. If you have the axe, of course. Now, this is not going to be an early game thing, but in the mid and late game, it could definitely be a factor. So, Bloodseeker, thirst scaling has changed, and I actually really like this. It's kind of the opposite of what they did last time, where they moved it up to 25, because you never got the max bonuses, because they were dead at that point. So, just gave you 25, and now it's not punishing people for missing that first 25% of health. Yeah. And the heal being reduced, it means you actually have to max blood rage. So, that's it. You can lane against this hero now. Congratulations. Yeah. Yeah. Bounty Hunter, this is a nice buff, or nerf, excuse me. Track now provides vision only of the target rather than the area around it. This makes it a lot safer for the rest of your team if you get tracked, because it used to be like one of your supports gets tracked and all of a sudden map hack on the enemy team. And it just wasn't fair. So, also the ally bonus gold reduced. We might see bounty still be played as a three position offlane with this. We might still see him be played as support, just very situationally. But this is going to mean he's going to be getting a lot more gold than his allies are. Well, his allies are still getting a pretty decent amount of gold. So, yeah. That's true, yeah. Okay. Brewmaster's Dispel has a big AoE increase. It's now triple the AoE that it was, and the cooldown's a lot lower. I will still say this is definitely a pro nerf, simply because pubs generally don't know how to use this ability, except for maybe to turn off the tornado, if they even know that. So, that's... Yeah, one of my first games, they played this hero called Brewmaster, and I never heard from him again. I think he was removed from the game. We're not really sure. Primal Spirits, the boulder, the rock toss, is reduced a lot more. This is a pretty big buff, because if I'm not mistaken, that's actually the spirit you start on when you split. So this is actually a pub buff right here. Also, because the Earth Spirit will stay alive. It's tanky. You know? Yeah, it looks like Plague might be joining us in just a second. Drag and Drop, if you want to keep going here, the next couple changes, I need to run to the bathroom real quick. All right, I'm back. Oh, at all? That's strange. Okay, just a moment here. I have no idea why that would be doing. They're just seeing me just sit here like, Oh, that's okay. Why doesn't it say Skype? Hold on. Just a moment. Technical difficulties. Okay. System sound default speakers. Okay. But you're hearing everything else, right? Like, Senpai? Okay, let me see here. Okay, say something now.
What?
Yeah,
Oh,
you're
he's
fine,
on a call.
Blake.
Okay.
You should be able to hear him now. So until that happens, I'm gonna assume that everything's fine. Here, so let me know in the chat, please. Sorry about
Yeah,
that,
I
guys.
just checked. They can hear me now. Hey, chat. How we doing?
Perfect. I'm sorry about that. I installed a game the other night and it installed some sort of surround audio codec, and for some reason Skype was like, "No, I'm not listening."
I
So,
forgive you.
yeah. All right, we're good now. So I've done a little solo patch analysis. Let's move on, I guess, to Bristleback, since obviously they heard nothing while I'd stepped away. Bristleback looks like a shrapnel bomb now to me.
It
20 damage, yeah, it's not that much, but you have to remember, this means that for him to do 2, it's now 40 damage less. For 3, it's 60 damage less, and so on, until this is
And
really stacked up fast.
Quill Spray works pre-mitigation, right? Like,
I want to
so
say.
it's just like whatever the raw damage comes across pre-mitigation. I think that's how it works. Let me.
Yeah, it makes sense that way. But why is Skype trying to make all these noises? I'm sorry about
It's because Skype wants to get in on the action too.
Yeah, clearly. I have ideas, guys.
But like the Bristleback, you know, he's been seen, but I think this is pretty solid. I like it. The just small it's a small buff, but it can get bigger, you know, as you were stating, as the time goes on.
That's.
There we go.
Don't really see it do. I actually might make quite a bit of a difference in, not really in the early game, because either you get enough Quill Sprays out from your own casting it, if you chase someone down, or else you're not gonna be able to take too much damage anyway, because I'm not gonna have a high level of the passive and not gonna have too much health to play with. But later on, actually, if you start tanking a lot, then it might stack up a little bit faster. Yeah, it's
Oh
much
my
easier to get to
goodness.
the higher stack charges. Not sure that it needed that buff, but yeah, it's nice
Yeah,
to see it comes.
it's a nice tiny buff, a power creep, if you will.
Yep.
We've got Centaur with return strength as bonus damage increased. This is a minor buff to Centaur. He's been picked, but he hasn't been picked a lot. And I think that's the kind of same deal. Now this is big. Okay, so Chaos Strike for Chaos Knight is now a mini Deso when you get a crit. And yes, the crit damage is slightly reduced, but this is, like, if you put a 1 point in the crit early on, this is actually really good.
Well, yeah.
That is really good. Yeah, as 5 armor damage reduction. How much is that actually in percent?
It depends on the armor.
Sure.
Yeah, but no, it's huge in the early game because
Yeah, of course.
versus supports, usually they don't have a whole lot of armor, and I. I've been a resident Chaos Knight picker for like the last year and a half.
Yep.
And even though he's been fairly weak, and they've been buffing him more and more over the last couple patches. And I believe it was last patch that we saw Chaos Knight have a bit more of a buff.
To the mana cost?
Yeah, to the mana cost of its abilities. And now with this Chaos Strike buff, I think that we'll see Chaos Knight actually be more, not necessarily a core pickup as like your Gyrocopters and Leshrac have been.
You could see mid as well, because if you're going to put 1 point in Chaos Strike early, you need levels.
Well, I guess when I said core, I was using a different term. I should have used more of like your tier one heroes. I think Chaos Knight will be definitely a tier. I think it'll be like a tier 1.5. I think you'll see him in certain games, but you won't see him be spammed as much as a Gyrocopter has been this patch. I really do like the changes in general that they've been doing to tweak the game, especially I know I wasn't here for the previous the previous heroes that you're going down through, but I think
there's like these nice little tiny tweaks, right?
Yes, and yeah. I think that what they did with Chaos Knight really brought him into more viability.
Yeah. And he needed a slight rework here. I mean, it's like, okay, you have a crit, cool. We've got like six other heroes with crits, and they've got better abilities than you. Just kidding, they don't, but everyone thinks they do.
It's making him a little bit more unique, and at the same time, it's one of these buffs that don't really do a whole lot in later parts of the game, because, well,
mm-hmm. High armor.
You're going to do so much damage anyway, and you have so much higher armor on the enemy team to begin with. It's still nice to have -5, sure, but it's not that big of a deal that it is in the early game.
Mm-hmm.
It's more of these kind of things where you have a buff just to remind people that the hero is actually there.
Right? Yes.
Just give him a little bit of a buff because he has really not been a good hero, not a good pickup. So you just experiment with things where you can change, that you can make him a little bit more unique compared to all the other heroes with wits, and at the same time just not overbuff him.
It's going to be the Ogre Magi effect, though, or the Lina effect, where it's like, okay, you're not going to pick this hero, well, we're going to buff it. We're going to buff it again. We're going to buff it again. And then all of a sudden, everyone's like, oh my god, it's so broken. Get it out of the game. And I'm just like, I've been playing this the whole time. I don't know what you're talking about. But yeah. -5 armor is 25-26% damage increase. Illumini's saying, if you get it down to -5, it's 26%. At zero armor, it's 30% extra. Wait a second.
It's -5 armor. It's 26.6% damage, physical damage reduction if you have zero.
No, I think.
Oh, wait, what?
I'm not reading this right, what? I think. It looks like 26 for -5, 6% at zero. 30% at 5 and 20% at 13. And this is extra damage. Anyways. We'll figure it out later, of course. It's more damage. Let's just go ahead and say it.
Yeah.
Chan is getting the numbers tweak.
I can't do math right now.
Yeah. Test of Faith actually has much less mana cost and cooldown. And I like this because it's a very RNG-heavy ability. It can do almost no damage, it can do tons of damage. Being able to spam it more is a big deal.
Yeah, it's actually the one spell that Shen uses besides his creeps. Did receive a small little buff as well, just to once again remind people that, hey, that is a spell is actually not all that bad. I mean, 30% extra damage once you max it up later on, at least. It's not something that you usually talk about, even if you do see Chen being played, but it's something that can make a difference, especially up against, especially with the amount of burst damage that we have been seeing in the meta. And yeah, these, especially up against tanky heroes, like, just imagine Alina with the Laguna Blade, Aghanim Scepter, against the tanky carry, and at 30% on top of that, right? It's same kind of effect like the Bloodseeker with the damage amplification from that, from the Blood Rage.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. Clinks is getting a smaller buff than I thought he'd be getting, so Strafe is a little less cooldown. This is basically an early game buff, I think, but late game it's also going to be okay. This isn't going to break the hero, this is just going to make him a little stronger.
Yeah. Well, Clinks is in a good spot. His main weakness is that if you catch him once, then you're usually going to have a really easy time bringing him down unless he's eaten the big creep and has some help coming.
Yeah.
So, yeah, and he really relies on the strafe to be able to actually get the pickoff. If he doesn't have to strafe, he's super slow in attacking.
And you also have to strafe to get out to the creeps. So there are times in the late game where I've had to, like, run through the jungle, like, to the enemy's lane. Then you have to stop and eat a creep. And then you don't have strafe. And it's probably the most frustrating thing about the hero. So giving it a little bit of a buff there can alleviate some of that, maybe. I'm going to go ahead and kind of skim through these next couple, because these are just tweaks. Crystal Maiden gets a slight Crystal Nova buff. Darkseer gets a slight intelligence nerf. Two is almost nothing. Let's be real here. Like,
I think it's
20 mana.
Yeah, it's a decent amount of mana. It's not something to make or break it, but the thing is, it's like with Darkseer as is right now, all you need to do
you
is
get Soul Ring.
Is you get Soul Ring and then you max Ion Shell and then you have 3 Ion Shells constantly. So, and it's really easy to catch back up as Darkseer. So, I guess maybe reducing the int by 2 might have a slight effect as to how the hero farms in the early game. I don't know. They know it way might. More than I do. So,
Gimpy Joe's asking, does this affect how many Ion Shells it can cast at level 1 with no items? I'll see if I can pull up some math on that in a second. As we keep moving here, Dazzle got a Poison Touch mana cost reduction, which is reasonable. Nobody was maxing this anyway. Some people will just not put any points into it. But now maxing it, it's not going to punish you as much. So
I think you might have more of an incentive to be aggressive in the early stages of the game, because at level 3, I think it has 100% slow and 1 second buff, 1 second stun. I think
at level 4 it has a stun.
Oh, level at level 4,
it's not going to affect it. Level 1, Gimpy. Even if this is the old value, still, it doesn't even come close. He still has a good 140 mana left over. So from the Darkseer thing, sorry.
Yeah, maybe that'll mean that Dazzle will actually level a Poison Touch and then be able to throw it out once or twice in teamfights without really having to worry too much. Because normally you can run out of mana if you don't have enough mana boots in your team and just have to spam Shadow Wave all the time. You can run out of mana on Dazzle, so you don't really want to use the Poison Touch. It's still kind of underwhelming later on. I still like to pick it up early if you... just 1 point into it to have a little bit of slow in the laning phase. And sometimes you can make something happen with that, but apart from that, it's kind of mad compared to what else he brings to the table.
Solomid Dazzle with maxing Poison Touch. Just watch
that
it out.
Could actually be interesting. could actually be interesting, because if you look at it, Poison Touch as a 1v1 ability, this shit does quite a bit of damage over time, all things considered, right? Because it lasts forever, if I remember correctly. So
yeah, it is a very long duration. So, but yeah, I don't know if it'll be relevant, but we'll see. The Death Prophet now, it's more damage, with that buff. The Exorcism Spirits are going to be increased from 6 to 8.
So it's two level 1,
yep.
one level 2, and then none on level 3. Which, so level 3 is fine. It's just, her early game is like she has a wet noodle right now. Guys, by the way, sorry about the stream going down. We got it fixed, it looks like, so we're good.
Yeah, level 1 Death Prophet Ultimates has always been one of the worst ultimates at level 6 ever. Right? Even if you have max witchcraft, it doesn't really do too much for it.
But especially if you don't have it.
Yeah, especially if you don't have it maxed out already. But these two extra spirits will just mean that you can sort of play a little bit of like a Dragon Knight if you want to, right? Just stick around lane until your enemy leaves, then pop your ultimate even at level 1, then take down a tower with that. So it's That's a buff to Death Prophet to work in this kind of aggressive meta where you have to do something with your level 6 and level 7 as opposed to a level 11 outside of the mid lane.
Yeah, and Disruptor's getting kind of a similar numbers tweak. Well, a pretty big buff to Thunderstrike, actually. The difference being that it only provides vision over the target itself, so much like Bounty Hunter's track is now. So,
yeah.
It's a pretty big rework, I'd say, but I wouldn't call it a buff or a nerf, either way.
The main thing for Thunderstrike is it still gives you vision of the target, so you mm-hmm. still have that huge range for the glimpse to play with, even if the target runs away, if you manage to time it well with Thunderstrike.
I'm just gonna look real quick. Okay, it's a 6-second duration, so now there's only a 3-second downtime in Thunderstrikes if you have enough mana to keep doing it. That's pretty crazy.
That is nice, but
because it's 400 damage though on a 9-second cooldown.
Yeah.
But now that's before reduction, but still.
But the thing is Disruptor, he in team fights, you know, I think what they're looking to do is make him a little more relevant because. Even though his ultimate is very, very good,
everything else is kind
kinetic
of
meh. Kinetic field is good. Glimpse is obviously great unless the enemy carry has a BKB or whoever he's trying to glimpse back has a BKB. But being able to dish out a little bit of extra damage as Disruptor gives him a little more relevance in the later stages of the game, and I think that's one thing that has been lacking with supports is having larger contributions in the later stages of the game. I'm not mm-hmm. saying that this is gonna have this amazing, just robust change that makes Disruptor.
Everyone
an amazing
builds Octarine on Disruptor now.
Yeah.
Actually, wait a second.
But
holy crap! You'd have like a second and a half of downtime on your Thunderstrike. Then that's actually.
That's pretty legit.
I'm gonna do it, boys. And I'm gonna lose, but...
On a side note, I just launched Dota, and the regional channel put me in Hamburg. It's like,
yeah, I actually
God knows
don't
how many
like
kilometers
this.
Away from me.
The but, only thing I don't like about it is that it just says... Like, if I'm on stream, I don't want it to say, you are in this town, in this state, because...
Yeah,
mine's
off.
Not right, so there. So I got that going for me.
Mine's Based close enough. No, I mean, people are gonna figure it out, but still, it's kind of like, I don't really want you to, like, have
the
information
the
right there. Yeah. You laugh, but it might happen.
Yeah, it might, but...
You can use the console command, Dota, join regional chat channel 0, with underscores and stuff.
I can probably do it, yeah, in, AutoExec, and fix it, so...
Yep. Yeah, you can just
yep.
use the console.
Anyways,
yeah,
Doom. Oh, I'm sorry, are we?
Yeah, I might actually have to bug out because Ted needs me to co-cast.
No, you're fine, man. You are perfectly fine if you have to go.
Yeah, I mean, I have zero faith in you to continue this through after the blunder. With me not even having audio.
I'm gonna wreck it, guys. It's gonna crash and burn, quick. Anyways, drag and drop. Thanks for joining us for a bit here, and
I can still hang
back.
Out for a little bit longer. Don't have
okay.
a lobby yet, so it's...
I'm gonna try to pick up the pace a little bit, so we aren't forever. Yeah, that's fine. Did I click on the page yet? I've clicked on the page. I don't know what you're talking about. Okay. Doom. Doom is getting a big buff to Scorched Earth. This is... 1.5 times as much. Let's just speculate at level 4. That's 48 HP per second. That's better than a heart would be on Doom at a lot of stages in the game. And of course, you can do you can use it in the early game when you're not going to be able to have a heart. Also, level death cooldown 1 second buff. That's good, but I still don't think people are going to skill it.
Well, the thing is with Scorched Earth and the change to it, the amount of swing when it comes from heal and damage is very significant.
That's true.
Because you're still going to be doing 36 damage a second to them as with that. That's after mitigation, prior to any sort of MR. All right,
does
like
it heal
any
allies?
Sort of I don't believe so.
I'm gonna check this, because I didn't think it did.
It heals you, I think.
Yeah, it might have been. Now you're making me,
Okay. I'm scared to try this, but there is a techies to click thing.
Restores health.
Oh, there's
it's only him. But yeah, it's only Doom gets healed from it, but the thing is the amount of swing between that damage and heal is very substantial, and we haven't been seeing Doom be picked up really at all over
Did you just do it too, Dragon Drop?
I got bad out now, though, so...
Scroll down to, Techies.
Okay.
Alright, I'll see you later, Dragon Drop.
Yeah, ladies, have fun.
Do I
You're gonna hate me.
The landmine? Oh,
that's,
man.
That's for you to choose.
Oh, cool. But,
I mean, that is something that we haven't seen picked up, and it's something that could easily get buffed here, so...
Yeah, I think we'll see Doom more and more frequently this patch. Probably less so than...
It buffs his offlane a lot, actually.
Like, I don't want
to
see him like...
Although, you would have to max Scorched Earth, so... Yeah.
Like, well, Scorched Earth is usually something... Yeah, it's something that you max usually anyway, so it's... I think it's a substantial buff. And, like, I guess moving down to Dragon Knight...
It's a laning buff.
Yeah, the debuff
actually, that's team fight.
The debuff is huge, actually.
Yeah, you have to remember the AoE, too.
Yeah, the amount of damage that they... The amount of damage that it mitigates from the breathe fire is just so substantial. And having it for like an extra 3 seconds, so like that's an extra 36%. Like it's huge. And
yeah, it's enough to be notable anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm sorry about the techies mines that I'm going to place all over the patch notes now, guys.
Oh, Lord.
Thank you, Cal, for pointing that out.
All I did was, I just F5 a dude.
I'm not going to do that. Play. That's cheating. I'll have to get some sentries out here.
Oh.
But wait, TrueSight TV. That's how we can see the mines. Anyways, Drow Ranger, numbers tweak. Since the nerf to Precision Aura, I actually like the cooldown decrease, but it's not going to be enough to really push a lot of games. It's just going to be a tiny thing.
It's a little bit of extra damage. It's like, it's 2 damage per 100 at every level, which isn't substantial, really, for the Precision
Aura. Oh, God! Plague, have you downloaded the patch yet? Oh my god, the treasure! It's so bad!
I did. Let me take a look.
Okay, the Queen of Pain set's good. Holy...
I'm gonna take a look.
I've got it in the corner so they can see it.
Is it the Treasure of the Burning Grove?
Yes! And please, put it in... What? Set it on fire and...
Whoa. Okay. So,
oh god!
Wait, does Crystal Maiden have black eyes? Like, did somebody punch her in the...
Okay.
That's actually really bad.
Time out from patch notes, this is the treasure review.
Oh man. Okay. Yeah, let's do it. Okay, so are we Hold gonna on, review the, Let the me, Crystal Maiden outfit first?
Bam! Okay!
Like, so...
So Crystal Maiden went out to the club, put on some mascara, or got beat up.
I feel like she got punched in the face.
Her
twice.
Sleeves were also slit. They cut them open for some reason.
And
you can see she's a little jittery. Like, she's being watched or something. She's like, they're coming to get me.
It's like, it's like she was out a little bit too late. She was out at the club. Probably did a couple things she shouldn't have that night, and she just woke up like that.
Also, the textures are just bad.
Oh, dude, I know. Like,
those leg textures are just terrible.
Look at the leg, and I have no idea. I'm running the game on... let me see real quick.
I'm running it on high settings, and it looks like I'm running it on low settings.
Anyways,
Storm Spirit, he now has a banjo. I guess he went to Redneckville and got some new clothes that he should burn. Legion Commander can barely see out of her helm. And also now has an axe. Other than that, it looks like a standard Legion Commander set. Juggernaut... Okay, that sword's actually pretty cool. Like, this set is good. And then last but not least, Queen of Pain is now blind. Yeah, she's just blind. Anyways, that's the treasure. I'm not buying it. That's for sure. Anyways. I'm assuming Plague has had to take a call, which is perfectly fine. We're gonna go back to patch notes and I'll just keep chugging along here. I don't know where Rupture is, but... whatever. We have Earthshaker. Oh, it's probably a liar. Yes, that's true. Thank you, Leatherback Turtle. It's a Rihanna set. Oh! Ouch. New Magnus set. I want to see that one. Please. But, anyways. Back to the patch. No. We have Earthshaker. Fissure damage reduced slightly. That's really all it is. Okay, I can't even see the set in that loading screen, but that's fine. Earth Spirit, Stone Remnant is placed in front of you, been double-clicking it. This is actually pretty big because it's a quality of life thing where when I've played Earth Spirit, I've had trouble, and I don't play Earth Spirit for that kind of reason. But again, it's just a quality of life thing. You could do this yourself. Anyway, so, Elder Titan, Stomp, increased area of effect slightly. Little tweak, Ancestral Spirit's mana cost doesn't take his whole mana pool. Damage per creep is actually increased quite a bit by a whole level. And the sticky duration of the aura is increased from a half a second to a second. Okay, that's it. Where's the Fall Compendium? No, really, though. Like, where is it? I want to buy. Okay. Enchantress. Nature's Attendant's Wisp count increased by 1. Okay, they broke Enchantress, guys. Enchantress is now so broken. Because not only does Impetus now pierce BKB, but it also is now not a unique attack modifier. So... yeah, Enchantress is now a viable pick completely. Because she could get Diffusal. She could get Deso. She could actually just get a Orb of Venom early game and run you down with it. And it still matters late game, mid game. So that's good. Enigma, Midnight Pulse cast time reduced slightly. That's going to help a Blinking Enigma a lot. Although the AoE is toned down a little bit, but Black Hole's radius is increased, which I believe it was increased rather recently as well. So yeah. Also, you can go Scotty Impetus. That's just scary. That is just scary. Gyrocopter. Rocket Barrage damage per rocket reduced by 1 per rocket. Total damage reduced by 30 per rocket. That's decent. Call down slow no longer pierces spell immunity. This was a nerf I actually called, a while back. Just because, ooh, Mjolnir would be insane as well. But just because it's a little stupid that you can't counter that massive slow with a BKB on Gyro. Hey, Plague.
I'm back. So,
no, it's all good. I understand. I'm just kind of speeding through the minor changes, and we'll talk about the more major ones.
Okay, and I
hear although Enchantress is insane.
The what?
Enchantress. Impetus is no longer a unique attack modifier. Like,
well, yeah. I mean, it's really good. You go Scotty, and just like slow them for
and
days.
You also have tons of tankiness, which is a problem for Enchantress, generally, so, yeah.
And, I really like that. It makes her more viable, because we've seen Enchantress and Chin, and we talked a little bit about the change earlier. Those kind of core junglers that were very, very important to us for the longest time,
kind of lost their like kind of lost their love affair with the players for a while, and so seeing these buffs to both of those heroes make me hope that we'll see them yet again, because I really do like seeing high level play with those heroes.
Yeah, we've also got a minor nerf to Huskar. His max Berserker's Blood, his Berserker's Blood magic resist per stack is a little lower, so you can actually do damage to him now. I believe the max you can get is 14, so it's actually only going to bring him up to like 80% magic resist. This is decent.
The you're talking about the Huskar nerf, correct?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah. I really like that. I don't think it's too much to look at though. He's basically the same hero.
Tons of damage. that one magic resist, that one magic res.
Yeah, you can't take
gonna,
it, right?
It's gonna be tons of damage now.
Huskar now trashed here. You can't pick him.
You won't even pick him anymore.
Invoker's getting a big change.
Go ahead. I really do like what they did just in general, because Invoker is one of my more played heroes, and I really like seeing that he's going to get a little bit of love this patch. The Alacrity change is pretty big. I mean, having
10 attack
the,
speed and 10 damage.
Yeah, it's very big.
This is basically saying you get a very early point of all three spells just to have that Alacrity and help you out in lane, because it does help, and it's a very low mana cost.
And even Aghanim Scepter is the change where it gives the extra stats provided by any of the invoked, like, you know, Clauswex or Exort.
On all invoked spells.
Yeah.
So you don't actually get, like, extra damage from Exort. You get extra damage on Exort's spells.
Yeah, so you'll get the extra damage from the Sunstrike, you'll get the extra damage from the Meatball. Okay. Yeah. I really like it in general. So,
this is a bug fix kind of thing. So, max level Deafening Blast, instead of it just exploding out from you, you have to click somewhere to target it. And
okay.
It'll still explode out from you, but
mm-hmm.
It's gonna aim there. Jakiro. Dual Breath's Fiery Wave now moves at same speed as its Icy Wave. Let's just call that bug fix, honestly, because it was annoying, but it's not that big a deal. The damage is increased, and if I'm not mistaken, that is damage over time.
Yes, it is.
These are minor number tweaks, and this is kind of the thing where Jakiro has been on the rise for a while. The Ogre Magi thing's happening, where it's like buff, 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 buff. Oh my god, he's so OP.
Yeah, I really well, we saw that Jakiro was being played as really one of those resident offlaners for a little while. Just a very good hero.
But
overall.
Then Yule's got nerfed.
Yeah.
It took him with it.
Mm-hmm. But being able to... they also nerfed Liquid Fire. I think that he was really good, even with not... He didn't necessarily need the Yule's because of how good Liquid Fire was.
But this kind of gives the Liquid Fire nerf back to him in a different spell.
Yeah, so
if you're more of a support, actually, Dual Breath is the way to go over Liquid Fire.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like what they did, just in general, with Jakiro. Seeing a little bit of tweak there is pretty big for him. Hopefully we'll see him more. I really like seeing Jakiro in games anyway. But,
yeah. They're still trying to get people to max Blade Fury on Juggernaut. It's not going to happen. I can go ahead and tell you. If people are picking Juggernaut, they are stuck in their ways from two patches ago.
Hey, man, I've been a Juggernaut Blade Fury maxer for a while, so seeing this with just all this change is huge to me anyway, because that extra 15 damage at level 4 with all that extra damage, it's beautiful.
What? Okay, Coddle gets an extra second of cooldown reduction. Nobody cared about that anyway. Skipping. Kunkka. Holy Kunkka. Okay, cast point on Ghost Ship is reduced. That's going to help you land it, unless you're, like, really good with Kunkka. X marks a spot. Let's just talk about this ability. There's also a minor damage increase on Tidebringer, just to kind of power creep some. But 8-second cooldown means if you're going to do it with an ally, you can have yourself constantly X'd.
Yeah,
or an ally constantly X'd. I'm going to go ahead and say support Kunkka is going to be a thing.
Hey, man, we saw it at TF4 I believe it was with, was it LTD that played it? With,
yes, it was. Yep.
Yeah, because they played it, the support Kunkka.
Then we'll also have to see the Shatter Demon buffs, because Shatter Demon Kunkka is just good.
Yes, I think Kunkka, I want to see Kunkka again, because he's a really fun hero to watch.
Yeah.
And these small changes are nice, but the thing is what they did with him last patch as well, was very significant. So seeing both of them combined, I think we'll see Kunkka a little bit more. Just in general, the cast points, it shouldn't be substantial at all, but who knows, we might see a little bit of, maybe a little bit of a change with it, how people utilize it, but the big thing that you're talking about is that X marks the spot cooldown, that it's just gigantic.
And yeah. Legion Commander is getting a big buff as well. Overwhelming Odds cooldown reduction is huge, especially for the way people have been playing her mid. I experimented with it for a bit. I wasn't successful, but I'm just bad, so that's why. Press the attack cast time is reduced from 0.3 to 0.2. That's a minor buff. Also, the last change, that's a big buff. Because I've actually had that happen, where you almost win the duel, and then she's like, I'm gonna hit this creep. And you're just like, no, Legion, why? He's got 4 HP.
Go home, Legion. I mean, Legion does have the base damage increase now, so yeah. By 4, so maybe...
I won't lose those duels, yeah.
Maybe you won't lose those duels. But, no, I really like them in general. The being able to spam out Overwhelming Odds a little bit more frequently is nice. Press the attack is... The cast time, I think, is pretty substantial because it's very good. Because it purges, doesn't it? Like, press the attack does purge, right?
Yes, it does. And it gives you a quicker time to purge, so that's pretty big as well.
Yeah, so I think that little change is very, very nice for Legion. But we're here, what we've all been waiting for, Legion Commander. Nobody cared about anything.
No, I'm not even looking at that right now. Yeah, Leshrac gets nerfed. We knew it was coming.
Yeah.
Jump distance reduced is actually really big. Yes. I like the fact that they left the cast range on it and only nerfed the jump distance, because doing both would have been crippling. But yeah. This is pretty big.
Well, that's the thing that everybody was really having an issue with, was with Leshrac. You know, you get out with like 150 HP and you're like, oh,
except yes. You're not out.
No. You're like, man,
you're like
I
a mile away from him, and like the lightning bolt just comes out of nowhere, and you're like, was that a Zeusalt? No, it's just Leshrac.
Yeah, and seeing that is very, very nice, because yeah. I think the hero's still going to be viable. I think the hero's still very good. It's just he's not as strong as, you know, he once was, because having a 200 damage AoE spell every 4 seconds is great, you know?
But you don't need more than that, let's be real.
Yeah, like, you know, having a 260 damage AoE spell every 4 seconds is just ridiculous, because, you know, if you get in, like, 3 or 4 heroes, it's an extra 180 damage to 240 every time you use it, which is just so strong. So I think Leshrac's in a good place right now.
Yeah, he's in a great place. I don't want to talk about the nerfs. I want to talk about Lifestealers, so we're going to talk about Lich. Sacrifice doesn't split XP with enemies. This is basically... It used to just completely remove the XP, then it gave XP to allies and enemies. Now it just gives XP to allies. That's another big buff to Lich. The other things are pub buffs, kind of, although you just need to delta split faster and you're fine.
I think everything with Lich is more or less a pub buff.
Because the sacrifice thing is a little different, but yeah.
Yeah, because, well, the thing is most of the competitive Liches, when you would play Lich... You would sacrifice the creep before hit the tier 1 tower.
So they wouldn't worry about that, yeah.
Yeah, so you
don't have to
worry about
it. But now you don't have to do that, and this actually lets Lich go contest a rune. So drafting him in that capacity isn't as much of a hindrance on your level 1 team fight.
And also being able to, being able to split your XP with your teammate or whatever and without having to worry about, you know, where the positioning of the enemy is nice. So it pushes your lane, like, not a substantial amount ahead, you know, like, one...
Wait a sec. Sorry, I'm thinking ahead here. It's all good. Just keep talking.
Okay.
Ignore me. But yeah, it pushes your team ahead a little more, and it's going to help a lot. I don't think we'll see him picked in the pro scene, though.
I think we'll see Lich be picked up seldomly.
Place I see it is with Alchemist because of the ice armor. I think Mike's ice armor with Alchemist is the best build ever.
Alchemist Midas for days. Right, because, you know, level one, you get 500 gold if you get that bounty
rune. Two more bounty runes and you've got your Midas.
Yeah, like...
it doesn't matter if you can't hit a creep. Could bring support Alchemist back. That was something they said last patch.
Yeah, it's so substantial, though, if you look at it. Like, the 500 gold, I mean, yeah, it was 400 was great, but that's another 100 gold. That's two more creeps. So you're already 500 gold ahead of the enemy carry. That's, you know, level one boots. That's glove of hate, glove of haste, or blades of attack plus, a clarity. But it's huge being able to have just that little bit of extra gold to propel yourself a little bit further ahead. I mean, yeah, it does kind of hamstring your level one because you are sacrificing your stun or your acid spray for that extra gold. But, you know, I really like Alchemist. I could talk about it for days, so let's move on.
Yeah, Lifestealer, his rage is reduced, and this makes it very efficient as a BKB. 16 seconds cooldown is pretty ridiculous on that. Also, he can now use Infested Control on Ancient Creeps, which means he can help your team push up with that damage aura, the armor aura, the health aura, and then he can pop out of it and still be Lifestealer and definitely have full health if he was in an ancient creep. I mean,
yeah, I love that change just in general because what the auras that they gave the ancient creeps this patch were actually very substantial. So being able to do that is really nice.
Yep.
Then we see Lina getting a nerf for the first time
in 6 years.
Practically ever. And it's kind of in a big way, because 100 less damage on your ult, which is generally pure damage, is fairly substantial. And the Light Strike Ray nerf in the early game is huge because, you know, you're losing a third of that damage that you would otherwise normally have. And the LSA, it does more damage than Dragon Slave does at level 1, which, you know, it's... Or used to, now it doesn't. But, you know, it's just a lot of damage that LSA would do in the early game. So seeing the nerf in the early game is pretty big. The Laguna, I don't think the changes... I don't think this is really going to affect Lina. I think we'll still see Lina. Because she's a really good control hero. She can burst very well.
Yeah, it's not going to be as much. Yeah, she's still good. It's not trash tier, though. So.
We're not going to see her not be picked, but we're not going to see her insta-locked, phase one
every single pub, yeah. Thank goodness. Lion's Finger of Death is getting a Ags buff. This is not even notable.
Mid-Lion, that's it, dude. We got it.
He still has no lane presence. I've tried it, Plague.
I know, but, dude, you know, you max Q, you hit him. And then you finger them, and then you farm up that Ags, and then you finger every 20 seconds.
For you having Ags, this is a lot better.
Yeah.
But it's still not great.
It's okay.
Talk about the big one, though, here. Lone Druid has a huge buff. Summon Spirit Barrel cooldown reduced from 180 to 120. You're maxing that first anyway. I don't think this is a big change. The second one, though. Bonus damage increased by 30 at all levels.
Yeah.
This is... You get level 6. You get 180 extra damage each time you and your bear both hit the tower.
Okay? It's nice. Yeah.
Yeah. Not to mention, when you get level 16, 300 damage. That is a rapier worth of damage right there. This is Wrecking Ball Towers. Okay? Like, it's going to just demolish towers. I think he's going to be back in the meta, finally.
Yeah, I mean, I would like to see Lone Druid rise again. I'd like to see the Bulldog pick it out and see how it goes. But we'll see. I don't...
Yeah.
I don't really have any opinion one way or another for your Lone Druid, because yeah, I think it's much needed, but we'll have to see how much it's going to affect it.
Yep. Now, Luna's getting a little tankier. Eclipse is getting a cooldown buff at early levels. I always felt like it was way too long early on. Also, her Ag Scepter beam count has increased, but literally no one buys Ags on that hero, so it doesn't matter.
I did it once in a pub, but I was also like, level 18 when everybody else was like level 12, and I was like 26 and 2.
So it was a stomp.
So it was a stomp. I got all of my core items, and for my sixth slot, I was like, well, why don't I just go Aghanims? Because they were already two racks down. But yeah, it's a clowny item. It's literally irrelevant. But I think the Eclipse cooldown reduction is necessary, because I thought it was, yeah, as you said, just way too long. Strength gain, it's only like, what, like 4 or 5 HP a level? It's not that much, but
It's enough to push her into stronger territory.
Yeah, I think she'll see a little more play, but I also think more carries will be seen play this patch, because not because of the buffs that they had, but because of what the changes to the top tier carries this patch.
Illumini has pointed out that the battle cry for Lone Druid affects all units owned by the bear. So the new meta is now you get your bear a Necro Book and a Helm of the Dominator. You get yourself a Necro and a Helm of the Dominator. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8 times 150.
Well,
No, hold on. Let me do the math. Let me have my moment here, Plague. That's 1,200 extra. That's a whole tower's HP!
Well,
oh my god!
I'm the guy in pubs that buys double Midas on the for bear. So
then
you could
do this.
Yeah, you could do it. You could.
That literally is an entire tower's HP.
Yeah, I mean the thing is you a lot of the we'll see what people want to do with it. But generally, when you pick Lone Druid, you suit the bear up, and then you like go battle bear, and you just
no. The bear can die now. As long as he takes down that tower every, like, minute. It's good. Anyways, yeah. let's keep chugging along here. Lycan's getting kind of the same treatment as Luna. The crit chance is big, but keep in mind, you're usually using Shapeshift to run away. So, it's really not that huge of a deal. Very rarely, I mean, if he's going to use it to chase you down, it's going to work.
You want to fight with Shapeshift up, so
keep in mind,
but I am getting another call, so I'll let you take over.
But towers can't be crit, so this actually does not matter. Wolves need no armor. Magnus, Empower cooldown is reduced from 12 to 8, if I'm not mistaken, and Blap2, you can tell me this for sure, because I know you play Magnus, like, way too much. This would mean you're able to get 3 Empowers off over the duration, which means that's you and 2 allies that get empowered. That's really big. Mystic Stakes damage and mana steal boost per jump increase from 25 to 35. This is actually mid lane Medusa's time to shine. If you time it right, you could one-shot the carry with this kind of ability. I'm almost 100% sure. Yeah, that's actually crazy. Murana gets a little more damage per level. That's necessary, I think. And Starstorm is getting a radius increase. That's really big. However, I don't think it's going to change the hero completely. So, we'll see. Morphling. Agility growth increase. This is actually huge. Because this is also Morphling strength growth. Increased, kind of. Adaptive strike damage rescaled. This is just the base damage, but if I'm not mistaken, it multiplies. Adaptive strike is now 1-point wonder, it looks like. Hybrid no longer hides Morphling or restricts its usage when a replicate is out. So basically, it also now works like Morphling. Morphling himself doesn't transform, he makes a hybrid. And he can also have a replicant. I don't think it'll change, we still don't see that ability, period. Yeah, I can zoom in a bit on the text, Capizzi. Welcome. Let me just make sure I didn't mangle everything here. Yeah, that's much better. Actually, I can zoom in one more. Bam! I should have done this a long time ago, it looks like. Where were we? Morphling? So yeah, Morphling's better. These two changes I don't even think matter, period. Riptide damage rescaled early on. Okay, this is saying Nagasiren is not a support. Except the Ags change says that she is. Okay. They balanced singing Water Lady. I don't think this is too big of a change at all. Except for support. She'll be played just fine as a core. As support, she'll be worse in the early levels, but you still max Riptide second after Ensnare, if I'm not mistaken. I don't play her as support, so I don't really know. For core, it changes the extreme early game, but not much else.
What are we talking about?
Naga.
Naga, yeah.
Rescale on the Riptide, not that big a deal.
I like the
Ags that no one buys.
I like the Ags upgrade. I like the Ags upgrade.
But really as Naga, it. Especially as a core, you need every one of your slots.
Hey man,
and then
you can
a little bit extra.
Your Naga. You 12 yeah. slot your Naga. You got an Ags on the courier. You have a courier that follows you around, so that
when you're gonna
swap
song,
out the
you
Ags,
swap your,
so
okay.
you can alt, and then you heal your team. Why? And then you swap out the Ags so you can have whatever item that you swapped it out for. You know, it's brilliant. It's brilliant, I say. All right. No, I really like it. I like the change for Naga. It makes her support a little less harassy, you know, because that was one thing that she was really good at was being able to do so much damage in the early game and without having to be punished inherently because she has, like, what, 6 base armor? So it's really good.
And it doesn't hurt her anyway.
No.
So.
Yeah, it's...
Nature's Prophet is getting power creep, basically. Faster cast time on Sprout, lower mana cost, level 1. This will mean it really is a 1-point wonder. Like, 70 mana for that? Hell yeah. Treant's move speed is increased slightly. Vision is reduced slightly, but keep in mind they're moving faster, so you're seeing basically the same area. Greater Treant base attack time is reduced.
That makes it where my refresher.
Oh my goodness!
Prophet is the best prophet.
That is double the attack time, basically.
Yeah,
let's just go
ahead
really
good.
Say that.
I'm a big proponent of Axe on.
This is
prophet,
really good now,
so,
especially
yeah.
if they die in the next 4 seconds, it'll spawn an extra treant.
Mm-hmm.
Basically,
I really
means
like
you
it.
Get 16 greater treants. Well, that attack twice as fast. This hero is terrible good now, like terribly good.
We'll see what
Bulldog.
The Admiral can do with it because that's the thing is you know we've been so we're so used to seeing Bulldog do so well on Nature's Prophet
this
and Low Druid.
This is a Broodmother who can TP anywhere on the map.
Yeah, so
it really is.
We really do need to see how the best player in the world at those two heroes do with them before we like kind of make a decision on if these heroes are great or not.
You only get greater treants from hero kills?
Yes. So,
oh.
Like,
well, it's still pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, I like it. It's good. Necrophos,
but still.
You know, screw you, Leaf Eater.
Leaf Eater is dead. Down with
anymore.
Leaf Eater. I have lost a few games to that.
I've seen it over that. Oh my lord. I wanted to just be like, hey, can you teach me how to play Necro? But
actually, don't, please.
Yeah, but seriously, don't.
I think this was something Valve said to... Okay, it was a cool change at first, but then it literally started ruining everyone's game. Because I think what they intended it for is that your team stacks Ancients, and then once you have your max Heartstopper aura, you go do Roche, and while you're doing Roche, gold just rains down on you. Not level 1, I'm gonna walk over to the Ancients and just wait.
Okay, yeah.
And that's gonna be the game.
I like it.
It's much better. And Sadus getting a slight buff.
Death Pulse to get better in the early game is big.
Death Pulse is usable in the early game now. It scales a little worse, but you still have to max it. So
yeah, I mean, what it actually scales.
The Night Stalker?
Yeah, the Night Stalker is big. Having this is 1.75 extra base regen is huge.
If you have an urn, though, you can really roam.
Yeah, the hero is already a roam support as is, so I really like seeing it.
This is an excellent roaming support now. Night Stalker is now epic support. I want him as a support instead of like, oh, well, I guess you can play support, yeah. Burrow Impale cooldown reduced, so Nyx, if he gets an axe, which we've only seen from time to time, but when we have seen it, it's insane. Impale and Mana Burn just get a lot better with that. I like that. Vendetta duration increase in the early game is actually crazy good. It's almost to the level of a smoke duration then.
Well, yeah, because Vendetta was really rough at levels... What?
We're just going to move on from that right now, Play, because this is my favorite hero in the whole game, the Broger Magi.
The Broger.
Yeah, base armor increased by 1.
Literally, no damage.
Why? Look, I just have to look up, like, what is it at now?
Wait.
Armor. He has.
Bloodlust can now be casted on towers.
Yeah, that's just stupid. Ogre has 8 base armor, basically. It's technically 7.96, but it's basically 8 base. I want to say that's the highest in the game, other than Terrorblade. Which means now, since I've read ahead, it's now the highest in Captain's Mode or something.
That is huge, though.
But Bloodlust can be cast on towers. I think we're just prepping for... What is it?
Treant Ogre
meta. Isn't it Arc Warden who can affect towers with the buff?
I've never played Zet, so I have no idea. I never played Dota 1, so
didn't either, but I read about it, I think.
I'm not familiar with the hero, but the thing is like being able to cast Bloodlust on towers is pretty substantial.
Fully affects buildings. Yeah, that is it. That's why it's been added, because they're actually coding Arc Warden into the game.
Okay.
Don't get too hyped, kids. Fixed a bug, also.
Yeah.
So, whatever. And also more attack speed. That's great for Ogre. Bloodlust is underloved, in my opinion. So, Plague, if you want to talk about Omni Knight, I have to use the bathroom again. Yeah. I have the smallest bladder in the world.
You're right okay. Back. Well, now we see with Omni Knight, he's got a little bit of a different cast point when it comes to purification. It's knocked down just a 0.15 seconds, which isn't that much, but it's a okay amount, right? You know, being able to drop a purification and heal your ally a little bit more quickly than you would have had been able to prior is fairly substantial. I know that when I played Omni Knight, or when I've had Omni Knight support me in my pubs, there's like, you know, if you cast purification and you're like hands on the ground to cast it, and then they die, so it's to, I guess, circumvent a little bit of that, so that's nice. The Degenora stickiness, it prevents them from just being able to run at you, I guess, with Degenora. I don't really see the need to nerf it, but I guess that's probably something that they wanted to do. So I think overall, the Omni Knight changes. I like the purification change. I don't like the Degenora change, but I guess they're just trying to nerf slacks. But also, Omni Knight does have the highest win rate in pubs in the game right now. It's like 60%, so
Will say purification cast point is actually a huge buff.
Yeah, I was talking about it a little bit ago.
I figured as much, but...
Yeah, because I've been there where I've been both the recipient and the caster, where you're just like, all right, if I get this purification down, you know, we kill 3 people and I save
my god,
support,
Omni,
or why
you
I don't
heal me.
Yeah, it's just
reported.
Like that. Yeah, it's just like
you
that,
reported.
So,
okay, Fortune's End. Which one is Fortune's End? Nobody knows this hero.
I have no idea.
Do we just say not in captain's mode and move on?
Yeah.
Okay, that's what we're gonna do. It looks like a buff. To everything.
Okay, Force Intent is its Q, okay. so it's the charge thing that
it's not the channel time, though.
No, it's the cast time.
Not the cast point either, which nobody really understands.
Well, the cast range is more, it does way less damage. The radius
cooldown is a lot lower, though.
Yeah, the cooldown's a lot lower, which is nice. The Purifying Flames cooldown reduction is cool.
Thank goodness there. The Purifying Flames cooldown is not that notable unless you have a ton of mana late game.
Yeah.
Fate's Edict no longer amplifying incoming non-magical damage is actually a huge nerf. This was, like, the best thing about Oracle. You could run into Roche and just kill Roche instantly, because you got 50% extra damage against Roche, basically. And he was disarmed. It was absolutely stupid good. OD gets a big buff here. Let's keep chugging along. And strength gain increased by, let's just say, 75.
Like .75. Yeah. It's pretty
significant. It's big. It's about 15 health a level.
It's point.
Okay.
4 or 5.
40% of max mana removed by Sanity Eclipse.
That's pretty big.
That's really big.
Because they changed it to where it's now the mana and
if you have Refresher though, that's 80% of your mana.
Yeah, it is. I really like OD. He's one of my more favorite heroes.
Hey bro, I heard you wanted to cast a spell.
Yeah, sorry bro, but I do like the changes that they've done to OD with.
Oh wait, no, I don't. Rip Medusa. Seriously, Medusa is just countered by OD completely now.
Hey man, she wasn't picked anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, but the big buff to her mid was big.
I think the buff to her W is big. The Mystic Snake change where it does extra damage, but yeah, I think you already went over that.
Wait.
Stifling Dagger now can crit a Maelstrom proc.
It can crit a crit.
Yeah, it can crit a crit.
It can MKB mini bash. It can bash.
Yes, it can.
It can bash. It can Deso. Woo! What else can it do? It can Scotty. Not that it even needed to, but it can't.
Blur no longer has a point. They buffed her, like, fairly substantially, actually.
Plague. It can lifesteal.
Hey, man, I'm okay.
It now has a source of ranged lifesteal. It's okay, not much, but if it crits, it's actually a lot.
I don't know with it though, like honestly, because I think I think PA did need a little bit of a buff to jump back into the limelight. So I think we'll see more of her. So I really like this buff to Phantom Assassin here. The blur change it's almost irrelevant, but
think about it though. A ranged Maelstrom proc?
Oh yeah, dude, it's a lot of damage.
But this is.
If you crit with the Maelstrom proc,
this is a fun hero now. It's not just I'm gonna throw a dagger and I'm gonna wait for a crit. It's actually a hero that does things.
I'm not gonna lie, the only time that I've ever really played Muffins, PA...
I do have to say, it does not guarantee a proc if the effect is chance-based. It can still happen. I do want to point that out. Which is something you have to take into account. So you have to think of it as, like, Basher's gonna go off about as much as your crit. And I'm gonna go ahead and assume that it's the melee bash chance.
Yeah, so the bash is 25%. So, and it's on a 4-second cooldown. So the likelihood of you having a bash every 16 seconds is fairly likely.
Yes. And
they should have just made it 17%, let's be real. But
I'm not no, greedy. But,
like, I like this change to Phantom Assassin, and I think she'll be good.
Yeah, Phantom Lancer is back to the trash can. Doppelganger not being instant actually makes it hard to use, which is great. This here ability was so broken. Agility growth reduced. He needed it. He's way too strong. Let's move on. Phoenix gets a buff. It's not much of a buff, but it's a buff.
The percentage health damage is pretty significant. It makes the laser bird a little better.
But this is also maxed last.
Yeah.
And you're an offlaner. If you don't have a Midas, this is practically nothing to you.
But you also do, you also heal more. That's also that's one true. Thing that yeah. makes Sunray very good is because of the swing of health in general. Because if there's somebody being healed from Sunray and damaged at the same time, it's huge.
Yeah, Hippie just posted in the TrueSight chat here. He's like, guys, Invoker, I do want, but he's not actually good, but that axe. Like, that's my thoughts exactly. It's like, wow, a great buff, but he's not going to be picked.
Hey, man. You know? I'm gonna make it work.
Okay, well they're saying Max Sunray may be the way to go. We'll see.
Yeah.
This is it now. Puck's illusory orb speed is increased. Travel distance increased from 1800 to 1950. We're back, baby. This is the new Storm Spirit, boys.
Hey, man.
Cooldown reduced! This is, right. without a doubt, my actual favorite hero. I say it's Spectre, and it really is, but don't tell Spectre, it's really Puck. Also, Dream Core cooldown increased is huge, because this ability wasn't good enough. It just wasn't.
Puck has, like, a 30% win rate, or 37% win rate, or something
in
like that.
In pubs, because people are bad.
Well, yeah, but the thing is, like, Puck in general needs a buff. Whether or not people are bad, it's irrelevant, because
no, they're bad.
We've even seen in competitive play where Puck really just doesn't do enough.
Oh, okay. Rot damage, though. I'm sorry I'm jumping on here.
It's okay, man.
Pudge is... Okay, level 1 rot is now insane slow-wise. It's 7% more slow at level 1. And this is when you don't have boots.
The more damage in the level 3 and 4... I mean, you do less damage early, but the thing is the slow's huge. I really like the change to rot. I like seeing these small buffs to Pudge. I don't think they're very substantial, but I think that... I also don't think that they're very... that they're incredibly relevant, but they keep Pudge, they make him a little more viable. So I would like to see him picked.
Yeah. Okay. Pugna is faster. That's good because actually in like core Pugna, it lets you get to the tower quicker through a Nether Blast. Nether Ward now placed at the target location. Okay, it's basically placed like a ward. This is nice. You can hide it a lot better. Life Drain damage steal per second increased once again for some reason. I'm assuming Ags is unchanged.
Yeah.
It's a buff.
They would have put a little bit of a note next to it. But yeah, it looks like... But I like it. I like the change to Pugna, being able to do a little bit more in... Like, as you said, with the movement speed, Nether Ward, being able to place the Nether Ward in, like, a small area is so nice, because I always hated placing the Nether Ward, because it was just, like, you know, because you have to put it right in front of you. It's so annoying.
Okay, Queen of Pain, it's a tiny nerf. It is really tiny. I don't think this changes the hero much at all. It changes it a tiny bit, but it's not enough to really matter.
It's 20 damage at level 3, and it's 40 damage if you have a refresher, so it's almost irrelevant.
Okay, Razor now drains damage smoothly over the duration rather than every second. This is like, every second you're near Razor, you're losing more damage. This is a big change, and it's a big buff to Razor.
I've always been really annoyed with how Static Link works, because
it
just bothers me that you're latched onto them and all you're doing is draining damage. It's like you're pulsing. It's like you're slowly taking out the damage, just tugging at them.
You're
now
taking it in
now
bulk.
It makes more sense.
And now it's like an actual stream. So
yeah. So
okay. Riki support. Donner Corporal British was saying this is going to be a thing. He might be onto something simply because the invisibility health region is increased and now he can roam, like. Crazy. 12 HP regen. At level 4. That's insane. It's crazy.
Well,
it's just crazy.
Being the resident Riki picker that I am, I spammed Spirit Breaker and Riki just... And I will continue to do so.
Yeah.
I think this is huge, because... I don't think it makes him necessarily competitively viable, but the thing is with Riki, I've always been
the max out invisibility 1 point in smoke screen, or you know, if I'm playing with my friends that flame me for not putting point in the smoke screen. I just don't put points in the smoke screen. I put like points in the stats and stuff too. But you always max permanent invisibility because it gives you so much sustain in the lane. And having extra 5 regen per second, that's, keep in mind, that is a ring of health.
It's a free ring of health while you're in.
That is 800 gold now. Because they made a change to it. It's 800
spoiler gold. Spoiler alert. Yeah, that's actually a huge change, though.
Yeah.
Sand King, barely anything. It's a late game buff. Shatter Demon, once again, kind of a late game buff simply because you won't be able to spam it. Maybe a little bit of a laning buff, but not that much. Shatter Shaman does damage with Shackles now at high level, and the cooldown's reduced a lot. I still don't think we'll pick him, simply because he's not good.
Oh, we've seen him.
We've seen him some, but he's still bad. He's bad.
Yeah, I don't think he's great. I don't think he's particularly good or bad.
Okay, now, Silencer fixed last word countdown debuff not being purgeable. That's a big deal.
So what they're saying is that now I won't.
You
have
can
to
stop
die
it from ever
last
happening.
Word. Yeah, no, yeah. I like this. It looks like they made it sound like a bug, but I don't think. I don't know if it wasn't intended, but
I don't either. But they fixed it.
Yeah, they fixed it. So that's
it's
big.
A slight nerf, but he was feeling a little powerful. Let's be real here.
Well, yeah, as Illidan said, you know, how to play Silencer, max last word, done.
Like, Skywrath Mage gets a slight cooldown reduction. Keep in mind, he still has mana problems. Mystic Flare no longer splits his damage over spell immune heroes. This is a bug fix, but it's kind of nice because then if their carries start getting BKBs and they're still grouped up, and like you Mystic Flare and there's a carry and a support and the carry pops his BKB, the support is dead.
Well, yeah, and the classic Clockwork Skywrath Mage combo.
Ooh.
If you catch a couple of heroes in at one of the heroes' BKBs, then it still makes Mystic Flare be incredibly effective without, you know, having to get like bleed away some of that damage onto a BKB hero. So
it's
nice. The concussive shot, you're not going to see that big of a change with it, but okay. I like it.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm really wanting to play now because we've been talking so long, but we will do this. We're just going to pick up the pace.
Slardar, man.
It's basically phase boots on demand.
I like it, yeah.
It's a 5-second downtime as opposed to a 7-second downtime. That's pretty nice, and it gives you more control over when you want to use it. It's one of the big problems with Slardar. It's not going to make the hero OP, but it's not going to leave him where he is.
No, they should have just made it a 17-second cooldown and let the duration stay, and then Slardar would have been pick ban number one.
Every 1 second, he like trips over a rock or something.
Right. Like when it goes off cooldown, he has zero movement speed.
He just needed to take a rest there.
Right.
Slardar must fully stop for 1 second in order to regain his movement speed. But then he's back to Usain Bolt. Sniper Shrapnel Delay is reduced slightly. Still way too long. Won't be picked. Spectre is back, baby. Okay, so Dispersion now reflects damage before reductions.
That's big, actually.
This is huge. You can, first of all, build armor on Spectre with no consequence. Second of all, Desolate now works on non-hero units if they are alone. Now think about this for a second. When do you run into non-hero units that are alone? You don't, right? But you do. You actually do. Simply because Roshan. And Spectre, I've long said Spectre's the worst at Rosh. It's like, I got a Radiance. That doesn't matter. Nobody cares. Well, I have a Butterfly. Nobody cares. You still don't do enough damage, Spectre. You have no lifesteal. Now, you do that. Oh, shit. It's a Vanguard buff, too. You reflect the full damage in the buff. Plague. I might just start playing Spectre right now on this stream. Because I got to start gaining the MMRs. That is, like, Spectre is now absolutely broken. I'm going to go ahead and say it.
Oh, okay. You know, I'm done, actually. Like,
she's
I just
so
read,
broken.
I just read the next thing, and now my heart is broken, and I don't even want to play this game anymore.
Random chance. What's wrong? You unlucky fools. You weren't good enough.
I'm actually upset.
It's a nerf to RNGesus.
I'm actually upset because, you know, I do my Hail Gavins every day. You know, yeah. my karma with RNGesus is incredible right now, and they just ruined me.
Okay, Storm Spirit's mana cost has increased a lot. This hurts his laning stage incredibly. It's not going to work. Static Remnant's vision is hurt a lot. And Ball Lightning Basement. Holy Ball Lightning, that's a lot of mana. This hero is absolutely garbage right now. I wouldn't pick this hero at all. I'm just going to go ahead and say it.
I think he's still a good hero. I don't think he's incredibly...
He's a good hero with Coddle. Okay.
I don't want Storm Spirit to be that, like, only... The thing is, one thing that's been bothering me this last patch was that there was just only X amount of, like, top-tier heroes, and then the rest were, like...
trash tier.
The rest were pretty trash. Doing this to them is very, very good, in my opinion. It changes the game.
Visage mid is now better than Storm. You're not kidding, though. Anyways, let's keep moving.
Sven, he's got a little bit of extra int, which
he got smarter, which is great. He needs it.
Yeah, because I don't know if it's enough to cast two.
Oh wait, two hammers. This is okay. I actually really like the Great Cleave damage increase. It's almost Battle Fury level 1, and it's 1% more. The later changes to it are completely irrelevant. Yeah, but, let's be real. It's like, okay, you get one extra damage. That one guy that snuck away from your cleave with one HP, he's fine. The early game changes are big. This is a pretty decent buff to Sven. We'll start actually seeing him. He's an okay hero now. Yeah. Techies, however, are not an okay hero at all.
You know, they should have just said Techies is now removed. Techies
has been removed from the game.
Like that's all.
I can't wait to go kill some Techies.
That is all I read here.
They don't do anything now. Techies mines no longer even activate. No longer activate.
Well, the thing is like now you can kill things with Quelling Blade.
They don't even do damage. It's free money.
Yeah, it's 10 gold every time. Oh my goodness, it's actually gigantic.
Damage is reduced. I mean, technically, they do the same damage, but they can be spread apart a little bit, which is nice. It's sort of bursty damage. Now, keep in mind, what's the remote mines are still exactly the same.
Yes. So, no, not really that...
Crap, Cappy. Capizzi. Capizzi has way too many emotes. Are you seeing this chat? Like...
I'm not.
He basically posted 16 kappas or so.
Nice.
I'm not even kidding. It's kind of ridiculous. Anyways, yeah, Techie's trashed here. Terrorblade is removed from Captain's mode. This is not a change, ladies and gentlemen. This is exactly the same as it was. I actually don't think Terrorblade was picked at all. Nope. In 6.84.
He was picked. He was one of three heroes that was not picked.
At all, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Terrorblade is removed from Katniss mode. It's an AoE reflection, which is big. The movement slow is reduced a lot, though. And the cooldown is rescaled a lot late game. However, the AoE means it could potentially... It's like Chronosphere, if I'm not mistaken. And that's big.
Yeah,
Also, Conjure Image Illusions are basically seen as illusions. Cast point is reduced from 0.5 to 0.15. That's really great. Metamorphosis is changed slightly, but that's fine. It's basically a nerf to the illusions, but they've also been buffed a lot. And Sundercast range has changed a lot. It's a big buff to Terrorblade. It's a change to Reflection, but a lot of people didn't even use it anyway.
The thing was, there was that, like, weird mid-Terrorblade
that max Reflection.
Yeah.
I think it's Icefrog saying don't play the hero that way, it's stupid.
Yeah. The thing is, it's like the hero did have like kind of a specific way to play him, and then like people would. Even though Dota's not supposed to be like that, where,
well,
you know.
Well, with Terrorblade in it, yes. It's not supposed to be picked. It's not a real hero, guys. Don't pick it.
Yeah.
Anyways, Tidehunter is now given the buff he needs to make the Tide Ogre Classic matchup exactly the same as it was. Timbersaw is getting power creep. That's pretty big, but we're still not going to see him picked, I don't think. Rearm channel time on Tinker, though, is a lot.
I still don't think I don't think that we're going to see Tinker picked because he can't flash farm. But we'll see him, but we won't see him like be rise back to the glory
Tinker
days. Yeah, the glory
we
days
so well.
Tiny is getting a huge buff
early game. That is enormous. It's kind of a we're sorry we've nerfed your hand grenade here. You could throw it a little farther kind of thing.
It's like, yeah, here you can have the combo. I think that's the combo at level 1.
Leech Seed mana cost is now reduced a lot. That's a lot more early game aggression from him. Fervent attack speeds per stack is increased early and late, but not really late. Well, that's like 5 attack speed late. Anyways, I'm just kind of moving along here. Sorry. Tusk Ice Shards mana cost increased a lot. He was too strong. Max launch time reduced. This is kind of nerfing his phase shift snowball.
Yeah.
Frozen Sigil no longer goes through spell immunity. Robber's Kick does damage.
Oh.
This is news.
Oh, thank the maker that they gave him an actually a damaging spell with the
oh no
X upgrade.
Oh yes, but oh no. Okay, so wait, holy shit. Undying Aghanim Scepter does nothing on Flesh Golem. It did barely anything. Nobody got it. Now increases Decay's Strength Steal from 4 to 10.
That is pretty
that
substantial.
Is, that's like, oh, 5 heroes? I just got 5 Ogre Clubs, baby. Right there.
Yeah, baby.
Now, Tombstone requiring a constant number of attacks, that's a huge nerf.
Well,
I hate that.
It was
completely
almost too strong, honestly.
It was way too strong, but it ruins the hero. Mm-hmm. I actually don't think this hero is good anymore, even with the Ags. It could be picked up niche. In fact, it's still pretty good in lane, but it's definitely a support and not an offlaner now.
Yeah.
I just realized I turned your so they know when you're talking clearly off.
Oh, nice.
Ursa's strength gain is reduced.
Why
is Ursa getting nerfed?
Okay,
he's getting buffed slightly.
Yeah, I think it's just it's kind of a rework at what he does well, and what he.
Yeah.
I like the change a little bit. I like seeing Earthshock have a little bit of lower cooldown because I personally like Earthshock as an ability anyway. So
yeah.
The nerf on Enrage for the multiplier is fine, I think.
Okay. Let's see here. Vengeful Spirit gets power creep. That's nothing.
Hey, man. What it is nice. Now we get a carry Vengeful Spirit. So what Havos wanted to do back
now
in the day is now you are able to do in general.
Venomancer
I appreciate
power
that.
Creep, it looks like. Yeah, Venomancer power creep. Let's just say that.
The Viper is another power creep thing, except I do like that it no longer goes through spell immunity, because I think it was
fair,
almost ridiculous that it did.
Almost.
But,
Visage gets a tiny buff. I'm still going to miss that if I ever play Visage. Warlock gets the biggest buff ever. He is now top tier, mid-Warlock, new meta. Seriously. I'm not even playing around.
MVP buff, you mean? Not.
It's
not
just
Warlock,
a Korea buff, yep.
But an MVP buff.
Swarm mana cost is rescaled. That's great. Cooldown rescaled. That's a huge buff to Weaver. He's really good now. Winter Wyvern no longer respects spell immune enemies in the area, but still affects the primary target. That's fine. That's a great buff to him, or nerf to him. It no longer is a 5-man piercing BKB ability.
Yeah, I think that...
Death Ward damage is huge.
Well, the thing is it no longer bounces at level
That's
3.
Fine.
You have
to
buy
bounce,
the Ags for the bounce. So what you get is you get the Ags damage, but... you get the Ags damage at level 3, but... Without the Ags, but you also have to buy an Ags for the bounces. So it's like kind of a Reese. It's a power creep form, and I like it.
Okay.
I personally like it.
Wraith King base damage increased by 7. That's huge, first
of all. Hey, man. You know,
that's enormous. Vampiric Aura, though, that's big, too, because you can actually, like, smoke push without being like, oh, look, there they are, you know? Mm-hmm. And the Ags is really good now. It's just really good, because the problem was, if you were dead, it didn't happen. So what they'd have to do is, if they killed your allies while you were dead, you basically don't have an Ags.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that's not the case. Let's go through items real quick. This is a quality of life thing for Clarity, Mango, Healing Salve. You can use them on allies a little differently. Cool. Aegis now gives you Ground Vision. That was something that should have happened a long time ago. Bloodstone respawn time reduction, 4 per charge to 3 per charge. That's great. This item is balanced now. It's actually fine. You have killed Storm completely.
Yeah.
Work now. He's not a hero. He's a creep. That's blue.
Yeah, he's no longer... He doesn't benefit from the Bloodstone as much as he used to. Because you used to just buy the Bloodstone and win the game, right?
Yeah.
Now it's a little more difficult, but...
It's still a good item on some heroes, except for Storm, who again is a creep. Bottle, 25 less health. Eh. That's fine, but it's not good. I don't like it. Active buff on drum is increased. Now that you're not killing units with defusal, the purge cooldowns reduced from 8 to 0. Recipe cost reduced on Crimson Guard, so it's more affordable. Dust of Appearance doesn't have a crazy cooldown now. That's good. Cost is reduced on Enchanted Mango. That's good. You can actually buy it as a starting item. This is great, actually.
Triple Mango is the start now.
E-Blade cooldown reduced. That's big. Cyclone cast range reduced a lot. That's the Lina nerf. Yep.
Yeah, I mean, it's necessary, honestly. Like, Yules is... They've nerfed Yules a lot, and
they need to, though. It's too good. Guardian Greaves is buffed. It's a little better, not much. Glimmer Cape is nerfed hard. Fade time increased a lot.
Good.
Cast range reduced a lot. Mana cost reduced as well, which is fine. Visual effect on initial cast is more obvious. That's interesting. And magic resistance reduced by 10%. That's fine, though. Heart of Tarrasque restores per second 4%. That's great. That's another Spectre buff. Keep in mind. Heaven's Halberd can now be disassembled. That's fine.
It should have happened forever ago, honestly. Yeah.
It doesn't really matter itself.
I honestly think it does have some...
That's a huge helm buff, though, if you're actually dominating a unit. And it's a bigger helm buff, because Iron Will is reduced by 50 gold. This is an Alk buff as well, because Armlet. Yeah, and a Huskar G, we're sorry, bro.
That's actually really big, as you said, the Iron Will. The Lotus Orb change is huge. Fairly substantial as well.
Yeah. A support can actually use that item now, if he can mm-hmm. form it. So maybe Storm will pick one up when he's played his support at TI7, Kappa. Mantis Style... Range melee cooldown reduced. Okay, so Mantis Style's better. Mana cost reduced. That's huge, actually, especially for Spectre. Medallion no longer pierces spell immunity and reduces armor values by half. Whoa there. I don't like that, though, because that's why Medallion was picked.
Yeah.
But, okay, it's harder to rush. Mjolnir Chain Lightning targets count increase. That's huge. It actually makes buffing to Mjolnir a big time. Moonshard no longer requires a recipe. Thank you. I hope it's disassemblable for some strange reason. But, sure. That's fine. Fixed interaction with Guardian increase.
It used to just... lower the cooldown, but not the stack limit.
It was
kind of a bug change.
This is the Lone Druid buff on Necronomicon. Now that's going to be built on him, Kappa.
Hey man, Pipe of Insight. You can now keep it courier around you with the Pipe courier. Of Insight, or
and the courier gets magic resist.
Yeah.
Also, the person with it. Power treads are nerfed a little bit.
Face boots are buffed
for melee heroes a lot. For ranged, they're kind of nerfed, I'd say. This is a Spectre buff. This is a Spectre buff.
Spectre
buffs for weeks. Plague.
What?
Spectre buffs for weeks.
Hey man, they're wasn't
the... Recipe cost is back! Recipe cost is back! Radiance is now OP! Let's go play some Spectre! Crawling Blade chop cooldown reduced! Scythe of Ice reduced, yeah. TP score reduced! So much! They nerfed your SFAs because... Hold on, Plank, hold on.
If we're gonna talk about big item changes...
Blab 2, your SFAs was horrible.
Change is Perseverance costing 150 less.
Yeah, that's pretty big. But Blab 2, don't you dare build phase boosts on SF ever again. It's absolutely terrible if you want to ever use raises in your life.
Well, it's...
It's bad, Plank. It's bad. Don't do it.
You can go like this janky SNY build that gives that makes you a race car.
I just want to say one thing though. Spectre.
I mean, Spectre is incredible this patch. Don't give like it looks incredible this patch on paper. Whether or not it's going to be, I have no idea.
Spectre's going to be great. I'm going to go play Spectre right now. This has been True Sight's patch analysis. I'm serious, Blake. This is Spectre time.
Oh, is it now?
It is. I'll be over on SP Evolution 5 if you want to catch that. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching. Spectre's OP now. I honestly think she's OP.